what's crazy about this weekend, me getting inducted into the Hall of Fame, I think, obviously at the time, bro, when I came here, you know, I was just coming here to hoop. I just came here to play basketball. I wasn't thinking about nothing else but just coming to hoop.
Mountains high as my hopes. It's crazy how I stay afloat. Still float through these clouds alone. Get lost in the haziness. Demons brush me. Anxiousness is crazy shit when I walk through the fog. Spend your whole life searching for what you already have. Some think they'll find it in a bag of cash. Your wedding rings are the expense.
Hey, we finally made it. Finally made it to CSI in Colorado, Idaho. Old stomping grounds. About to check these boys out in practice. Maybe get them a few words of encouragement. Yeah, y'all come check out my my championship. Rings and tings.
Weather. Still undefeated, I made weather. I know I'm doing it right. The universe sending me signs in bold letters. I see the writing on the wall. Went to Europe, put the writing on the wall. I remember back when I was playing ball. I ain't really wanna do that shit at all, but I stuck it out. Mama ain't raised no quitter, my papa ain't raised no sucker. You let a free blessing slip through your fingers. You look like a dumb motherfucker. Not me. Now we in NY. Take a Uber to Harlem to get us a chopped cheese. Crazy this last year. Travel whole globe. Still feel like I'm not free. Why is that?
Richard, that's our trainer. That was our trainer. He's still here. He helped me when I shot at my elbow before I came out here, before I came to CSI. He got my elbow back right, and now it's how my gun is like it is now. But yeah, they got him a bigger room. That's a blessing. That the shit was small as hell. It's right loud. Yes, sir. Got the boy on the walk. Okay. Got the boy in here. I think that's because I'm coming or not? It's because I was on my way. It's crazy. I think now it's like hitting home. You feel me? It's like, these little dudes messy as hell. This is my locker though, look. I'm in somebody's locker. Look at this shit.
That's Maurice.
Look at that.
Pierre Jackson. All right, our news. 70-64, 6-point lead, and a steal by Pierre Jackson. Is he put on a show in this tournament or not?
He's
Pierre
an amazing
Jackson,
player.
And he's fouled.
He is absolutely amazing.
Is there any doubt who's going to be the MVP? The College of Southern Idaho from Twin Falls, Idaho, are the national champion of Division I men's basketball.
I remember one night in particular that was pretty special. I think we were playing Salt Lake. It was near the end of the season during Pierre's sophomore year, and down on the baseline, down where I sit, I had to move that night because we had some VIPs in the house. That night we had the head coach of Mississippi, the head coach of Auburn, We had Coach Ford from Oklahoma State that had flown in on T. Boone Pickens' plane that was parked out at the on the runway at Twin Falls Airport. We had some other coaches there, all there fighting for seeing Pierre, and another coach that was there that kind of stood in the background and let it all happen is the one that ended up getting him at Baylor, and that's Coach Drew. And lucky for Coach Drew and lucky for you that you got to be with Coach Drew. It was a great run. It was a magical year that ended in a magical moment at the NJCAA tournament. And Pierre, we've been very proud of what you have done with your career and your life since.
I remember when Pierre got drafted and I was out of coaching and laying on the couch with my wife and we're watching the NBA draft. And I was like, I think he's gonna get drafted. We gotta watch this. And he comes, his name flashes across the board, and the only thing I could think of, because Pierre's first year, he had his elbow injury, and he was in a sling for forever, it seemed like. And our fearless leader had a great idea that we should go on a camping trip and hike up some mountain. I'm from South Georgia, so I don't know what the names of the mountains are around here, but we were, cliff diving off of these mountains, and I thought to myself, as Pierre's name's flashing across, he's getting drafted in the NBA, and I'm like, man, we had that poor kid in a sling in Chuck Taylor's from Las Vegas. He hadn't seen a tent in his life, and we had that poor kid hiking up a mountain. You need an insurance policy to do that nowadays. And here he is, he's getting drafted in the NBA. Man, we almost messed his life up there on that mountain. So
it was tough, you know? And I remember the first time we got out of practice with that group, and we got up and met in the office. And I remember telling, our staff, I don't know how good this is, how far this is going to go, but I had fun today. I had fun coaching those guys today. And you know what? You can feel the specialness of already, just coming from those guys that they just would do anything, I mean, Pierre was our point guard the whole time, and we asked him to move off the ball and give Smitty the ball. Smitty came off a hand injury, didn't play all summer long, and shoot, he couldn't even bring up the ball in the scrimmage in Salt Lake, in the Jamboree. And, Isaiah Grayson, Fabian, Isaiah Grayson was, led the Big West in scoring after he left here, for 2 years. And Isaiah played backup minutes and never complained one bit. Fabian was one of the all-newcomer team in the SEC. And, he backed up Pierre. And I tell you, that's what we see in this community all the time. People doing just selfless acts of kindness to make these kids feel special and to make us all feel special.
Basketball-wise, I didn't know anything but basketball. School wasn't a thing for me in high school. I just wanted to play. So me not being eligible, it made sense. I understood why I couldn't go to school because I didn't go to school. When I was in high school, I just wanted to play. So when I got here, at first, I really didn't go to school when I got here either. I figured it out, man. The coaching staff set on me with that, and I wanted to play. So as soon as around the time I told Ghost, I wanted to go to UNLV, obviously you needed grades. So I tried my hardest to, get my grades right, and coming with that, we were able to play really well. Get into Hutchery, I got to see, you see one coach in there, you play well. Then the next day, you see 10 coaches in there. And then the next day, we win again. As long as you keep playing, you see more coaches. And the second game, I seen one coach from Baylor. Second day, I seen two coaches from Baylor. Third day, the whole coaching staff was there. The boss man, Coach Drew, was happened to be there. And we all balled out. And we got a chance to win the national championship. And that day, it's cemented in history here. And this opportunity to be here is obviously for this Hall of Fame ceremony is crazy. It's obviously not seeing everybody's faces here is making it even more crazy. When Joel called me, I was in the middle of figuring out what I was going to do in China, and obviously that brightened up the situation there. And obviously coming here and seeing all my old teammates all on the walls, and just seeing again all the faces and seeing his kids about tall as me now. I didn't grow much at all, but just being able to come back and see everything, obviously all the stuff that's changed outside of the campus, inside of the heart of the campus is pretty much the same. It's just special. I'm not gonna cry like these, but it's just special to be here, man. And I'm very thankful that I made this decision to come here. And I want to thank all you guys for coming here. And thank you.
I'm just trying to find a way out. I come from where you can't even hang out, yeah, yeah. But my niggas still hang out. Ratchet on my hip, I'm tryna bang out. Ratchet on my hip, I'm tryna swing some, yeah. I ain't with all of that talking, I'm tryna say some, yeah. He don't really want the problem, now niggas spazzin' now. I do it for myself, tell me what's the cash in mind. I'm positive as you not, feel like I'm riding away. When I be loadin' the chop, feel like I'm back in the A. Thumbin' through rats every day. These niggas be full of the hate. I still gotta slide with a cake. Gotta let these niggas know I'm playing. I'm a shooter by myself.
Fuck my motherfucking self.
I do it by myself.
I
ain't never been the type to call for help. Load a chopper up and shoot it by myself.
I do it by myself.
I'm a shooter by myself.
Yeah.
I do it by myself.
I
ain't never been the type to call for help. Load a chopper up and shoot it by myself.
I do it by myself.
Watch me do it by myself.
By myself.
Don't be mad, cause I'm bad for your health.
For your health.
Don't be hating, cause a nigga bringin' racks. Pocket rockin', make a nigga check itself.
Check itself.
I got my strap in the club. Ay. Niggas knowin' what's up. Ay. I don't really want no problems. Bitch, I'm by my dollars, but a nigga get the trip and I'ma step.
Watch me step.
When you start to get the money, that's when niggas turn sour. Gotta watch my back like every day and every hour. Think I'm going crazy, but niggas better know I'm body. Niggas killing they homies, so trust a nigga, I doubt it.
I'm a shooter by myself.
Yeah. I do it by myself.
I
ain't never been the type to call for help. Load a chopper up and shoot it by myself.
I do it by myself.
I'm a shooter by myself. I do it by myself.
I
ain't never been the type to call for help. Load a chopper up and shoot it by myself.
I do it by myself.
The plaques ring Pierre Jackson in recognition of Pierre Jackson for his outstanding basketball career at CSI from 2009 to 2011, the Region 18 Tournament MVP, NJCAA All-American in 2011, and the Player of the Year at the 2011 National Championship team as he led the team to the NCAA National Championship game. Inducted into the College of Southern Idaho Hall of Fame on January 18th, 2020. My friends, sports fans, I give you Pierre Jackson.
How can I trip when I'm
petty. How can I trip? How can I flip? I'm from the ghetto, the car, the bitch. I'm in like peace, down in Paris, c'est tout le jour, et c'est la vie. We've been trying to get the sheep, popping now we got it. I ain't stopping bringing the heat. I got the flame, you soundin' the same. You scared of the chain, we shoot and we aim. I'm on the plane, back in the day. They was dying on the hustle, brother, don't you know where I came from? East side, come alive, you don't work, you don't survive now. Couldn't think about it too much, man. I have to climb now. Why wait, gotta go get it, man. Look at the time, I'm standing around.
Today, like when we had this ceremony, it was crazy to see all the people that, you know, that showed up and got a standing ovation. It was crazy. That's wild, man. Just looking back on it, they showed so much love. Like, I didn't think that was gonna carry on to like to where I'm at now. Like, I still got CSI fans that write me. To this day, follow me on every social media platform I have. All the kids that were younger then are in college, and you know, seeing pictures of them when I was their age, it's special, man. This place is special. You know, they made me feel special coming here, and it's just a great weekend that I probably won't ever forget, man. Especially being able to bring family out here and my kids. Kids, my mom, and everybody just got a chance to see where I spent 2 years of my life, and again, it's probably the best decision of my life, basketball-wise, and it's a great weekend. I mean, I'm glad we got a chance to document this, man. They sleep, man. Live or die, CSI.
Tiptoeing through your crib, tripping, falling your wrist. Still being a fat ass, catch me all in your fridge. You gon' rub this baller belly like a crystal ball. Wishing it was permanent instead of on call. I wish that I was more involved. But I'm so passionate about what's happening around me. I wish I could put it on pause more often, just so we could do what grown folks do.